Hello everyone, this is Darsh Italia. Welcome to my channel Darshonium. In today's video, we'll be learning about the features of the modern periodic table. In my last video, we saw that the Mendeleev's periodic table had failed. So the next attempt to classify the elements was done in the year 1913 by a British scientist, Henry Moseley. Henry Moseley, while analyzing the frequencies of the X-rays emitted by the elements, found that the properties of the elements were related to their atomic number and not to their atomic masses. The atomic number are the number of protons or the number of electrons in an atom. And hence, in the modern periodic table, we see that all the elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic numbers. Now, let us learn the statement of the modern periodic law. The law states that the properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic numbers. So, based upon this law, he made this table that you can see on the screen, which is called as modern periodic table. Now, we all know that the modern periodic table has 18 groups and 7 periods. The 18 groups can be numbered in two ways. First is by simply numbering them from 1 to 18, as you can see on the screen. Method 2 is by using Roman numbers. According to Roman numbers, there are 8 groups in which 1 to 7 are further divided into A and B. Now, we all know that the modern periodic table has many tall columns and many short columns. All the tall columns, we will use the suffix A, and for all the short columns, we will use the suffix B. Group number 1, 2, 13 to 18, all are tall as compared to the group numbers 3 to 12, which are comparatively shorter. So all the tall columns will be given the suffix A and all the short columns will be given the suffix B. So let us start numbering. Group number 1 is tall and hence it is given the number 1A. Group number 2 is also tall and hence it is given the number 2A. The next tall column is group number 13 and hence it is given the number 3A. 14, 15, 16 and 17, all of these are also tall and hence they are given the numbers 4A, 5A, 6A and 7A respectively. Group number 18 is called as zero group because it consists of the inert gases. So after 1A, 2A, the next group is third group and it is short and hence it is numbered as 3B. So group number 3 is 3B. Group number 4, 5, 6 and 7 will be given the numbers as 4B, 5B, 6B and 7B respectively. We'll stop at 7B because we have taken groups only up till 7A. Now, we can see there is 3A. Group number 13 is 3A. Before that, group 12 is present. The 12 group is shorter and hence it is numbered as 2B. Group number 11 is also shorter and hence it is given the number 1B. Now, group number 8, 9 and 10, these three groups are together called as group number 8. And hence, this is the way in which you can number the groups by using Roman numbers. So, in this way, you can number all the groups of the modern periodic table by using Roman numbers. Now, let us learn the features of the modern periodic table. The whole modern periodic table can be divided into four blocks, S, P, D and F block elements. Let us learn the characteristics of each and every block. First, we'll start with the characteristics of S block elements. So, point number 1. The S block consists of group number 1 and 2. Point number 2. All the elements which are present in the S block will have either 1 or 2 electrons in their outermost orbit. Point number 3. While writing their electronic configurations, the last electron will always enter in S orbit. Point number 4. All the elements which are present in the S block will have their last shell incomplete. point number 5, except hydrogen, all the other elements which are present in the S block are metals. Now, let us learn the characteristics of P block. Point number 1, P block consists of group number 13 to 18. Point number 2, all the elements in the P block will have 3 to 8 electrons in their outermost orbit. Point number 3, while writing the electronic configurations, the last electron will always enter in the P orbit. Point number 4, all the elements in the P block will have their last shell incomplete. Point number 5, the zigzag line which is present in the block divides the block into two parts. On the left hand side of the zigzag line are all metals, and on the right hand side of the zigzag line are all non-metals, and on the border of this zigzag line are metalloids. Point number 6, the P block contains all the three type of elements, which are metals, non-metals and metalloids. Now let us learn the characteristics of D block. Point number 1, D block consists of group number 3 to 12. Point number 2, all the elements in the D block will have their last two shells incomplete. Point number 3, while writing their electronic configuration, the last electron will enter in the D orbit. Point number 4, the D block elements are also called as transition elements. Point number 5, all the elements which are present in the D block are metals. Now, let us learn about the last and final block, F block. Point number 1, F block consists of two additional series which are present at the bottom of the periodic table, which are lanthanides and actinides. Point number 2, all the elements in the F block will have their last three shells incomplete. Point number 3, while writing the electronic configurations of F block elements, the last electron will enter in the F orbit. Point number 4, these elements are also called as inner transition elements. Point number 5, all the elements which are present in the F block are metals. So, this was my video on the features of the modern periodic table. If you liked this video, please smash out the like button. If you have any suggestions or any queries or any doubts, please comment right below. Share this video with all your friends. Thank you for giving me all your time. I hope everyone enjoyed. Sab log maze karo. Thank you.